So we'll start the session now. Today's topic is interaction design and how to create interactions when creating different kind of digital products. So whether it is website or mobile app or any other kind of app, and what is the importance of interaction? What are the different elements that makes the interaction? So on. So we'll talk about that at a detail level, but yet we'll cover at a very high level importance of interaction, and then we'll get into the protopy, and we'll try to see like how we can use protopy to create different kind of interactions. Right. So this is the protopy. We'll use this tool. Protopy is a very not very old, like it's 2-3 years old. It came. The company is from South Korea, and they have developed this very powerful tool. So by using this tool, we can create very detailed and very high advanced interaction. So we'll see like what we can do during in this workshop. Okay. So before we start talking about or like going through the application, we'll understand what is interaction design, because it's very important to understand before we start using the application or the protopy. So as a UX designer, it's very important to understand the difference between the terms which we often get confused. So basically, what is user experience, what is interaction design, what is user experience design, and so on. So there are like so many different terms, but and each has its own purpose or role in the entire process. So when you talk about the UX process, it is the whole from the start till the end. It's the whole process, and it includes interaction design, and the person who does that is called as the interaction or the user experience designer, right? So basically, interaction design, when we talk about interaction design, it is the basically how the person or the user is interacting with the product. What is the way, like what are the different elements through which the interaction happens, be it the words, be it the physical shape or other things, you know. So that is basically interaction. Basically means the communication that happens between the user and the product. So if you see the definition, it says that the IXD or the interaction is the design of interactive product. What kind of product? Interactive product and services in which a designer focuses beyond the item and development. So he doesn't focus on the development, it's basically focus more at the end result. So it's basically the interaction and how the user interacts with the product. In other terms, we can say that it is the creation of a dialogue between a person and a product and a service. So when we talk about the dialogue, it is not necessarily the physical interaction, but it's also how the product is able to emotionally connect with the user. So that is basically the interaction design. And when we talk about interaction design, it's important to understand where it stands when compared to user experience. So user experience, as I have said earlier, it's the whole sum, but interaction design is part of that. And when we talk about interaction design, we talk about 5 dimensions of interaction design. So these are the 5 dimensions. So basically, first is words, then is the visual representation, then physical objects and space, behavior. These are the basic 5 dimensions of interaction design. And when we as like when we're working as interaction designer, we need to consider each when doing or creating the interactions, right? So first is the words. Words are basically what? It's all the text that you use creations in your designs and solutions and products. So basically, it can be like the small word or the text on the button to the whole copy of like how you are, what is the language of the copy, what is the tonal quality, and so on. So basically, how whether you're writing in an active voice, passive voice. So everything has to be defined and designed in a proper manner so that you are able to emotionally connect and rightly or correctly with the person who is using the product. So that's the user. So your copy or the words that you're using in your design should be meaningful and simple to understand. First, the second is the visual representations. So whether you're using icons, whether you're using the images or any kind of illustrations, how does that connect with the overall design and the experience, and how that affects the user? So you need to understand that and then use the right kind of visuals. So that's why like visual plays a big and very important role in the entire interaction design, so the whole experience. And then physical object or space. This is one of the most important things. So like suppose you're creating an app for a delivery guy. So you need to understand how will he interact in the real scene or in the real world. So he'll always be using your product when on the road. So you need to understand like what place he's using the app. So one, where does the user uses the app? So that's very important. Whether he's sitting, walking, like he's, if it's a game, like he'll sit and play the game, right? But if he's like a delivery guy, then he'll use on the go, like while delivering the product, he'll use the app and like do the activities. So you need to understand when creating the interaction design, like where is he going to use the product. And then time is basically how much time will he use. Like so if someone is or you are creating a product which is game, so the user will spend more time, like it may be like 20 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours or more. So you need to define the experience and the interaction thinking that in mind. But in case for a small activities, the user might spend only like 2 minutes per day, so then the interaction will differ and you'll have to think from that angle. So time plays an important role when defining the interaction design. And similarly, you need to understand the behavior. So that's the fifth dimension, and you need to understand, like, when the user performs the activity, what is his emotional and the other behavior? So how does he feel? What is his feedback when using the product? So these five dimensions are very important when we talk about the interaction design. And interaction design was conceptualized by Gillian. He was the one who came up with the first four dimensions, and the fifth dimension was added by Kevin. So if we talk about the interaction design, we need to understand this and remember this five dimensions. Before this Protopi, like I've used many apps, so with Flinto, Principle, I tried using Framer and so on. But what I've seen is that Protopi is a very powerful tool. It's a very simple tool. Like in Framer and other tool, we need to know the coding logic and all those things. But in this case, it's not like that. You can simply, like, by spending some time, you can adapt in using this Protopi, and then after that, you can create very advanced interaction design. So it's a good tool. You can use this tool to create prototypes for different kind of channels. So be it mobile, desktop, or like any other. And it's very good because what happens is, like, you can easily explore, validate, and test your design. So basically, before giving it to the developer, you can yourself, you know, like, whatever idea you have during for the interaction, you can simply create that using this app and then hand over this interaction to the developers. So it becomes very easy, and you don't need coding. So since we are designers, we are into creative, we don't know much of coding, so it's a very powerful tool. So we'll see, like, how we can use this, leverage this tool to create very advanced interactions. What can designers do with this Protopi? Experiment different ideas that they have, and they can create the right interaction using this tool and then hand over to the developers. One. The second is validate assumptions. So before getting into the development and then testing in the development itself with the coder, so you can yourself validate whether the experience or the interaction is really working or not. So it's very important from that point. The third is communicate interactions. When you're working in a big team, a lot of people are there. So in that, what happens is, like, it's always good to, you know, show or present your thought process before getting into the development. So in order to get the approval from the stakeholders and other team members, so it becomes very important, and you can easily, like, communicate your interactions, like your ideas, and then get the approval. Since the key role of the interaction designer is to create the interactions, so by using this product, you can create wonderful interactions, advanced interactions, and then you can get this approval, and then you can validate, and then everything. So that's why it's a very important tool for the interaction designers, because when we work in a small company, we do all the activities. We do the research, we do the personas definition, then we do the wireframes, then even the UI, and then the interaction too. But when you start working in big companies, then you might only be responsible for doing the interactions, and then having or knowing how to do the right kind of interaction or design the right interaction or the experience is very important. And if you want to grow yourself or, like, grow as a interaction designer, then I think, like, this tool is a very powerful tool, and by knowing this, you can really grow well professionally. So that's why I say that this is a very powerful tool, and you should learn this tool. Why this is a very powerful tool? Because in this, you don't need any coding. You don't need any programming language or knowledge about the programming language. So it takes the object, and then on that, what you can do is there's, like, predefined triggers. You can apply the trigger, and based on that, you can get the response. So you can to create small interactions and even advanced interactions. And we'll see, like, how we can do that. So there are three different elements, and these are basically, one is the object, that's the primary asset or the primary object where you want to apply the animation or the interaction. And the trigger is basically what kind of animation or the interaction you want to apply, and response is the result. This is what we'll see, like, how, and this is what we'll do in the Protopi. This is one of the kind of, like, periodic table. So basically, on the left is all the triggers, and on the right is basically the response and the mix of the two. And you can achieve n number of interactions by cooperating or using few conditions. So that's why, like, it's a very advanced tool. why it's important tool or the advantages of this tool is, one, slow learning cost, because it's similar to the other design tool, be it HD or like Figma or Sketch. So it's similar to that. So it becomes very easy to learn this. It is code free, so you don't need any coding language. It uses the example of the real world, and basically you can refer that and then create interactions. So it is so advanced that it makes the use of the sensors. So that's why like it's a very advanced tool. You can test the tools, test the interaction on the real mobile apps. It's very easy, very, very advanced, and you can test it. And then also, you can use the interactions, whatever you did, by recording that and then giving the handover to the developers. So it's a full-fledged, like from the start till the end, you can do that, and you can hand over the interactions to the developers. So similarly, this tool can be used to hand over the interactions to the developers. And we'll see like how we can do that. So if you want to download this tool, so you can go to protopie.io and you can download. Good thing is that this tool is available for both for Windows and macOS. So both can use this. If you have like Windows, you can download and try this tool. If you are on Mac, you can try that for both the platform. And also, once you're done with creating your interaction, you can download this player from the App Store and then you can test that interaction. So it becomes so easy to see that in the real world. If you're used to any of these two, like Adobe XD, Figma, or Sketch, you can use that skill and then start using Protopie to use that learning and then create the interaction. So you can simply import all your designs into this Protopie and then start using it. Other is, you can start using the camera features. Similarly, we can create the real interaction, real feeling of how the forms are filled. They have this input field and the interaction. So we'll see how can we use that. Similarly, we can use different formulas to create high level of interactions. Yes, native player is basically you'll have the player to test the application. So that is it. And then we'll see how the things are developed. This is basically the learning or the tutorial that they have provided. This we saw. So basically everything, you can apply interaction on an object and then there will be a trigger and then you'll get the response. And this is the periodic table that they have created for this. And let's get to the main points. So as we have in other tools, be it Sketch, Figma, Adobe XD, they also follow the same kind of layout or the property. So basically they have this panel, which is called as the property panel. And with basis or depending upon the object that you have selected, this will change and you can modify and improve or like customize the layer. And then this is a good part. So if you want to like apply the scrolling in your app, so you can use this feature scroll. Similarly, if you want to apply something that goes horizontally, you can apply paging. We'll see how we can do that. The best is like you can import your existing designs from Adobe XD, Figma, and Sketch. And as we have artboards in Sketch, they have scenes, so it's similar experience. So that's a good thing. And the best part is that we can easily record all the interactions that we have created. So, and we can share with other people, and it becomes very easy when you want to like, you know, explain your concept or the idea to the other people. This is shortcut, this is fine. What all we can do is like these things. So tab, double tab, these are the different interactions. I'll try to like show you how we can achieve these. So these are like so many different, and it becomes so easy for us. You know, everything is there on the app, just like by providing few interactions or the triggers, we can get the response or the right interaction. I think I should get in the app and we'll explain. So this is a tool. Okay, so here what we see is on the left at the top, this panel, we have this import section from where we can import our files. So I have created my file from in Sketch, so I'll show you how it works and how I can import easily, and then I can start using or creating interactions. Then if I don't have an existing file, so if I want to create everything here, I can do that using these elements or these tools. So basically, if I want to import image, I can simply import image. If I want to import any video, audio, camera, Lottie, so this is the animation, so I can easily import these. So these are really advanced stuff. Then shapes are similar to the other two, like rectangle and oval. But here what I can also do is, like, if I want to create an interaction where I want to blur the background, I can do using this. See, you can easily blur this, blur the background. And then we have this normal text. So this text is simple text, but if you want to create something advanced, like we have when we are creating the forms, so we can do that using this input tool. I'll show you how it works. So this is the input, and these are all the properties of this. And I can easily, suppose I want to ask for full name. I can simply go here and put the TMP text to full name. If I want to create other things, so I can do that, but like I'll keep it simple. And also like, okay, let me show you this first. See, the best part here is as I click, I'll get this keyboard, right? So I can start putting my name and this will stay in the interaction. So by using this small experience, we can create the intuitive extractions. And the best part here also is that we can customize this keyboard. So let me create one and put this as mobile number, right? And for this, I want the keyboard to be numbers. And we can rotate, these are small properties, you know, I can, if I want to increase the height and all, or this for the position, so I can do that easily. And I can change the phone, this is regular to the other apps, so I'll not talk much about this. And that these are the basic things. So container is normal group, what we do in the other apps. So suppose I have these two elements and I want to create a group, I can use this and create a container and then drag and drop this into this. So this will become a container for this. So this is basically the group. And here what I can do is I can resize this, I can place this inside this and change the position and all. So now this is basically one group and I can customize or like do whatever I want with this group. So this is still simple, but the best thing here is this scroll. So suppose this is a container and I want to create a scroll here. So let me show you how I can do that. So basically I will take this and put this inside this container. This is like a scroll. So this is a scroll, right? So this is what I've created. So I don't need anything else to do. So I can simply see the scroll is done. But it's so simple to create scroll here. See, and it's so smooth. And I can make it more smoother by using few elements here, right? So this was like vertical scroll. If I want to create a horizontal scroll, then what will I do? Now, in order to create a horizontal scroll, what I'll have to do is, this is scroll, I'll just have to change this. And you see, I got a horizontal scroll. It's so easy. Now, let me show you, okay, before that, so this is where all these artboards or these scenes reside. And suppose if you have created some components, so let me create one component. So suppose this is one component, and if I want to create a component, I can convert this into a repeatable component, and this is like box and green or something, whatever it is. So whatever you want to name it as. And once you have created a component, it goes and resides here. So this is the component. So this you can use when you're creating a complex or like big application or this product. So this is where the component resides. And then I'll show you how the painting container works through the real example. And now what I have here is like 375 by 812 size of the screen. So if I want to change that, I can go here and I can change the sizes. If I'm working on some desktop website or product, I can go and change my size here. But if I want to create my own, put my dimensions here or sizes here, and I get the customized. This is the core or the main important part. So basically, I can add a lot of triggers and create interactions like tap, double tap, touch down, touch up, long press, fling, pull, drag, pinch, rotate, and so many different things. So I'll show you a few of them right away, right now, like after explaining this. Whatever you have created, if you want to preview that on the device, you'll use this tool, preview. And if you want to use that on your mobile app, the real mobile app device, mobile device, then you can scan using this IP or this QR code and you can straight away see that on your mobile and this is cloud, this is upload, this is simple things. So I'll show you a few of these examples. So like suppose this is the object and you want to add some trigger to it. So basically I'll add like tap. What I want to do is I want to move. So let's start with move. So if I want to move this to 30, put anything and we'll see like how it works. I did this and I put it tap, see it moved. This is just small example, but we can use this interaction to create advanced interactions. So, and then if I want to add one more trigger, I can do that. Let's take scale. So I want to say that increase by percentage. So once I do this, increase it to 110%, or like in make the size to 110. So let's see now. So I click, see the size also increased, right? Let me increase the size more. And go modify this to be 138, 155, something like this. And then here, I can make it 130. Okay, 130. Right? So now see what happened. So you see, like there are so many different triggers here. So tap, double tap, you can do a lot of interactions using these. So like as I showed you, by just tapping on this, I can move this to, I can move, I can scale, just by play using these triggers, and you can easily get the response. So what we saw here was like by using tap, we can do like few activities or few interactions. Now let's see what other things we can do. So we'll see that we can also do some activities on the load itself. So like on the start, as the screen loads, we can do some activities. We can, like suppose if I want to rotate this with 25 degree, okay, as soon as it starts, let us, anything happened? Nothing happened. Start with jump, rotate. Okay, why it didn't start? Because we didn't select any layer. So see, we'll have to select that layer. So this is rectangle one, we'll have to select this, and now it should rotate. See, but when you'll start combining different triggers and then creating the interaction, it will, you can create like advanced interaction. It depends upon your thought process, like what you can achieve by using these, right? So on start, I want to rotate this, and what I want the opacity or the color to be something else. Let's see, on the color to change to orange. See, try one more. And let's try this. I've not tried this yet, but as this opens, which we want to open a website called HTTP. Let's see. See, this opened. So we can create so many different interactions. Now let's try something else. So double tap is same, we can achieve that. Touch is same, double tap, touch down, touch up. So we can create two interactions. Like suppose on the click of this and on touch down, we want what? The color to change to this. Let's see, down, color changed and nothing is happening. So if we want this back to some other color, what we can do is we can create one more interaction. So this is basically touch up, and then we can change the color. And this time, if you want green, so we can do that. Now let's preview this. And this, what I'm showing you is the basic interactions. And then what you can do is you can add different conditions to it. And these are simple conditions. Like if rectangular one is equal to something, then do this. If the value is this. And this is a little mid-level advanced, but yes, this is very simple to understand. We'll cover this in some other sessions, but this are really, you can easily learn this. This is not like that difficult. Okay, this is a little complicated, we'll keep it later. Now I'll show you something else. So I have this app, this fuse. I'll show how to create interaction in Protopie. So let me import this. So this is walkthrough one,
So let me import from sketch. This is how the import screen looks like. So I can go to walkthrough 1, and when importing from sketch, we need to import it at 3x, otherwise it will become very small. So import all the layers. So this is what I get, right? And this is basically, we can rename it walkthrough 1. Now let's create one more scene and then import. Similarly, we'll have to import all. So this is what we got, right? And this is dashboard. So let's create the complex one first. So we'll start creating right interaction here. So let's group everything and put in. Okay, let me create first container. So this is basically a scroll container is what we want. So I'll create a container this and rename it so that I don't get confused. Scroll container, and we'll put everything inside this. Right, but yes, now we'll have to resize it properly, or we can use this also, 8.2. So we have this, and I want to, okay, I don't want this here. This should be above, this should be out of the scroll because this won't move. And similarly, this bottom nav should not move. We have this bottom nav here, this should also not move, so I'll just keep it here on top of everything. And let's preview this. So this is what we get. So simple. Now we'll start. See, this search doesn't have an interaction, this doesn't have an interaction, these also don't have an interaction. So we'll create interaction here now. So now I want to create interaction for search. So I'll just hide this and we'll use input. Here I'll come and customize this. I'll remove the border. If I have any border, I'll remove the border. I'll change the font size, and instead of input, I'll put that default text to search. And what else? Yes, I don't want this. I want Proxima Nova. So I'll use Proxima Nova. I want the font to be 14. So I've customized this as per my need. So I have this now. Now what I need to do is I need to add scroll to this. So let me add the scroll. I'll have to drag it to the right place. This is explore scroll. Now it's scrolling. You see? Like, it's so simple, it's so easy to create these interactions. And this we could easily get by keeping this outside the main page scroll. Similarly, like what we have added here, we can add here also. Here also, if there is something, or here. And it becomes so easy, like it looks like the real app. And now, if I want to search, I can simply and then done. Now let's see how to go from one scene to another. Now this is my action. This is basically next something. So if I want to go to the next, what I can do is I can add tab, and then I can add this sub interaction. That is basically the destination where I want to go. That is basically jump, go to a jump. Jump where? Walkthrough 2. And done. See, and now here what I can do is I can add jump, I can add fade in, pop, slide in. Let me add slide in. Okay, fine. So we are already there. Let me refresh this first. See, and then you can also like create interaction for each element. So that's like little advanced, but you can like by learning. By creating the small interaction first, and then you can learn the other stuff too. And now let's do the same for the other screens also. So by tapping on this, this is next. I want the trigger to be tab, and then I want this to jump to 3. And interaction to be slide in, and this is default is good. We have done for this, but for this also I want, this is back. And on the tap of this, I want to jump to the walkthrough 1 and slide out or slide in from left to right. Let me create first and then we'll see like how these things are working. So we have this. Now we are back here, but what I want is like when I tap on this, I want to tap and jump to what? Fourth one, the back. And the transition I want is slide in. You can try other transitions also, but I'm just using one for explanation. And then this is a design that I brought from Sketch. So here what I can do is I can add my input. You know, I can change the color to be, okay, this is that color. Where is the background color? So this is fill color. I can change this to white. And I can change this to full name. I can customize the style. I made a duplicate. I can keep it this on the top. And I can change this to, thank you, Dilip. I can change this to, where is it? This was mobile, right? And in this mobile, I want the input type to be number. So I can put number here and make a duplicate of this and put here. Email is email, so I'll put it text or email format. And this is email. Perfect. And on the tab of continue, I want this to go to the next. So jump to the dashboard, and I want the transition to be fade. So let me delay it with some millisecond. So let it be. And then let's go and see like how the experience looks like. So let me refresh. Okay, I'm here now. I tap on this, I go to the next screen, I tap on this, I come back. You can enhance this experience, but this is just to show you like what we can achieve. Again, tap on this, go to the next screen, tap on this, go to the next screen. See, I didn't put any interaction there, so it just, it faded and came. And then I came here. So here I can put my name, so that is 1312C. I can put mobile, 1234578, whatever I want. Then I can put this, so it looks so real. And go, we can put the, or here, like continue. Okay, we don't have the interaction here. Let me put the interaction back and see like why it's not working. This is continue. Okay, so this is tap, continue. On tap, it should go to the dashboard. Okay, it's taking time, so let me put it 0.25. Let me refresh. See? So the interaction is complete. The basic interaction is complete now. And here we can also, I'll show you some advanced stuff also. So let me create one more screen here. Yeah, it's very advanced, like you can do a lot of things. So let me show you. These are simple, tap, double tap, touch down, and touch up, long press, fling, pull. You can also create variables and you can use that. So basically this is the place where you can create variables if you want to store some numbers. So And this is like, if you want to carry the variables or the numbers from one screen to another, then you can use for all screens. If you want to keep that in the same screen, then you can keep for this screen. So let's keep it variable. Then let me create one more variable two, and then create one more total. And if you see here, you see you can put the default value of this. So let me put it 10 for one. For two, variable two, let me put two. And then total, I can. So basically you can do calculations also here. So this will say start and then assign. So see here, what we can do is for this variable two, variable one, so you can do the calculation also, variable two, and let's see. So by default the value showing here is zero, so this is the default value. If you want to see the runtime calculated value, so it's 30. So you can easily do these kind of calculation within this tool. So when you're creating some shopping cart and you want to like calculate the total amount of all the items that you have purchased, so you can do that using this. And it will take some calculation, it will take some effort, but you can achieve that level, that advanced level of interactions and the calculations also within this app. So you can use variables, you can use formulas, and then let me put one object. Like you can create different conditions, like condition 1, condition 2, condition 3, and you can add multiple conditions. And basically you can create with advanced level of interactions. Let me try camera. So the start of the page, the screen, I want the camera. So let's see. Current camera, front camera, whatever it is. Okay, I have to add camera. So this is the camera. If you'll use in the real app, so in the demo, so you can see this. Let me try. Can you see this? This is the camera. So these advanced features also you can use in your app. These are like a little advanced ones. So we'll discuss in some other session. But these are like simple ones, and you can start using from day one. And these are all about the sensors, sounds, and all those things. And also you can import, I'll show you. You can import audios also. Like if you want to import audio, let's say this, you imported this, and now if you want to create some interaction, so you can do that. And I discussed about these, and I discussed about these also. So basically this is a scene, this is the screen size, toolbar, interaction panel, variables, and so on. And this is a tutorial, like full website that they've created for learning. So if you want to learn more, if you want to like deep dive into each and everything, so you can use this tutorial to learn more about this tool. And I recommend everyone that you should at least download and try this tool, because you will love this tool. This is like one of the best tools. We have like Plinto and then Principle and so many other tools, but this is like one of the best, and you will need minimal coding, minimal programming, and then you can create very advanced level of interaction using this tool. Right, so this is what it is for the day, guys, and I'll recommend everyone to use this tool.